Chris Menard here. We're going to download some data from the Federal Reserve Bank regarding 30-year mortgage loans, the different interest rates they are. We'll put them in Excel. We'll analyze the data in Excel. We'll create charts. We'll figure out payments. We'll use conditional formatting. Let's dive in. There are chapters listed down below if you want to jump around. I am on the Federal Reserve Bank of St. Louis. Notice that I'm sitting here looking at 30-year fixed mortgage averages in the United States. You can look at this 10 years, 5 years, 1 year, whatever you want to do, but I'm going to pick max. When I pick max, it goes back over 53 years. I've already said I want to see this monthly. The default, if I select edit graph to the right, the default when I got here was weekly, ending on Thursday, and I changed it to monthly. To download the data in the top right, you click on download. You've got options. I want to select Excel data. My data has been downloaded. I'm just going to open up the file. When the file opens, select enable editing at the top if that shows up. Before I start working in this data, there are two things I want to do. First of all, it is listed as compatibility mode. I want to get it out of compatibility mode so I have all my Excel features that I want to. And the second thing I want to do is I'm going to copy this worksheet. Just in case I want to leave all this information in the original data, I will frequently do this with data. So to copy it, I'm going to hold down the control key, click, drag the worksheet, let go of the mouse, and then let go of control. I've copied the worksheet. I would normally go and right-click and hide this after I call it original data. Just to save time, I'm not going to rename the worksheets or hide this one. To get it out of compatibility mode, simply go to File, click on Info. There is the compatibility mode warning. Click on Convert. Click OK. Click Yes. The file is now in XLSX format, so it's not in compatibility mode. I did rename the worksheet I'm working on. So I'm going to select rows 1 through 10. I don't need them. Control minus or right-click and delete. Do a little bit of renaming. I'm just going to call A1 date, and in cell B1, this is 30-year rates. Type in 30-year mortgage rate. Name it whatever you want to. Go ahead and make A1 and cell B1 bold. Those are your header rows. No big deal to me, but that 7.31% in cell B2 is actually should be 0.0731. I don't care that they have it as 7.31. I'm going to let that go, but you could change it. The date format is the year 1971, April 1st, and then 1971, May 1st is right below it in cell A3. I'm okay with those date formats, but if you want to change them, just simply go to A2, Control Shift down arrow, hit the drop down where it says custom. Just to show you the custom, I'm going to go to more number formats. Someone selected the number tab, someone selected custom and did 4 Ys for the year, 2 Ms for the month, and then 2 Ds for the day, and there's that sample. Just hit cancel. I'm going to hit the drop down and make it a short date. Doesn't matter about the date format, it's just a matter of preference. So now I've got 4/1/1971 for April 1st, 71. If you want to chart this data, I can already tell you this is going to be a line chart just because we have control down arrow. We have 641 records of data right here running through August 1, 2024. By the way, today is September 14th, 2024. So I'm just going to add in here September. And I went and checked, the rate is 6.3% right now, so I typed in 6.3 just to have data into September. Back to the top with Control Home. You don't have to do this, but I prefer working in a table, so I'm going to do Control T to make it a table. Click on OK. Table design appears at the top. If you don't like the table style, you can change it. I'm going to actually select this one in the very top left that says none, so I have no style, but it is still a table, so when I click in my data, it still says table design. When you get a table, your filter drop-downs appear automatically in A1 and B1. Let's go and make this a chart. Go to the Insert tab. We have a group called Charts. I'm going to use Recommended Charts. I can tell you it's going to show as a line chart somewhere. Perfect. I'm going to pick this second one here. That is a great line chart. Hit OK. Feel free to move the line chart around and put it anywhere you want to. The data starts in 1971, and it's running through, obviously, 2024, but they stopped at 2023. We can fix that in a second. I am going to tweak this chart just a second. It's going 0, 2%, 4% over on the far left vertical axis. Just right-click, format the axis. I want to see 2.5. I think that would just look a little bit better. I change that in the units for the major. Click OK. For right now, I'm just going to move the chart out of the way. Let's go do a little bit of analysis and find out some averages, median for the interest rates. So my first thing I want to know is how many records do we have? I'm going to type in the word records in cell E1. Over in F1, I'm going to use count A. I'm going to select right below column A because this is a table. When I click, it selects everything and it says table, one, date. 642 records, just to prove it. Remember, I typed in 9/1/2024 in A243, so that is correct. Let's go find out what is the average mortgage rate. Over in cell F2 equals average, highlight, and 7.723. Maybe we want to know the median. In cell F3, I'm doing the median function, and I come up with 7.38. We could do the mode. Equals mode singular. I'm going to pass on that one right now. But I do want to know the lowest and the highest. So I typed in lowest in cell E4 and highest in cell E5. And those functions are equals MIN. Tab. Still doing the selection trick. 2.684. And then the max. I bet we're going to get 18 or 19 if I had to take a guess, because I'm old enough to remember this from the 80s. Let's see. 18.454. Yeah, it's in here somewhere, I promise you. Shows that in the chart, too. You don't have to do this, but I'm going to select them and hit comma style on this right there. Now, interest rates are 6.3% today, which is September 14th, 2024. The Federal Reserve is meeting next week, and they are discussing cutting the interest rates or cutting the Fed rate 25 basis points. 25 basis points is 0.25%. That is great that if they cut it, the mortgage rates should go down. My issue with the mortgage rates going down, not that that's bad, but when mortgage rates go down, depending on supply and demand, the prices of homes that are on the market go up. So you could actually end up spending more money waiting for the rates to go down. So. But I do want to know, of the 642 records we have, how many times has the interest rate been below 3%? So I'm going to go to cell E6, and I'm going to type in below 3%. This function will be the count if function, equal count if. This function has two arguments. What is your range? I'm going to grab my mouse and select the 30-year rates, picked them all up, comma. Argument two is, what is your criteria? In quotations, I'm going to do less than the number three. 12 times has the rate over the 642 records, 12 times has the mortgage rate been below 3%. What about, though, between 3% and 4%? So just I'm going to abbreviate between 3 and 4. I'm putting that in cell E7. Tab over, I'm in cell F7. I could get away with count if for below 3%. But because I'm doing a between now, between 3 and 4, we need to use count ifs with an S. So count ifs, tab. The range is, once again, the mortgage rates, comma. What's your starting criteria? I'm looking inside of quotes again. Greater than or equal to 3, comma, and then it's asking me for criteria, range 2. I'm going to grab my mouse and select mortgage rates again, comma, And now it's asking for criteria two. So this one inside of the quotes is going to be less than 4%. Let's see if that works. And I have a total of 71 records right there. So if you want to see the percentages, right next to the 71 in cell G7 is going to be equal F7 divided by the 642, which is F1. I'm going to make F1 absolute reference just to pull it up for that 12 and then make those percentages. So there you go. So over, this is 53 years. If you want to see the formula for that, how many years? Let's do that now. How many years? I typed in the word years in cell E8. I tabbed over. I'm going to use equal, and I'm going to put the today function minus cell A2, and then I'm going to divide by 365. Because one of them is going to give me the number of days, the first part of the formula, divided by 365. Let's see what I get here. 53.49, so 53 years in 6 months, basically. That is how much data we have. I do want to make that I'm just going to make that something without a function, so I'm going to pull it down, pull it back up, and just copy here as values only, because I may sort the data, and it may not be A2 later. So 2% of the time, we have been below 3%, so the odds of getting back below 3% are not that good, to be honest with you. But between 3 and 4, we're sitting here at 11%. If you want to see the 12 times we below 3%, go to cell B2, control, shift, down arrow. You selected them all. On the home tab, we have conditional formatting. Highlight cells rules less than, just type the number 3. I'm going to put this one in a green fill with a green dark text and hit OK. There they are listed here. Back to the top. To test this, you don't have to, but if you want to hit the drop down in cell B1 and say I'm going to sort smallest to largest, you can. Highlight those, and they're in the status bar at the very bottom next to averages count, and it says 12. If you want to continue on, go back to cell B2, control, shift, down arrow, and I'm going to go to conditional formatting, highlight cells rules, and I'm going to do a between, and let's put in between 3 and 4, and I'm going to put that one in yellow and hit OK. Back to the top, the count of the yellow is 71, which matches what we have here with the count if. So we're using count and count if, and we're also using conditional formatting. I actually do this quite a bit. Nice little feature there. Now, let's get advanced and let's figure out the average home price, I believe, the median home price, I believe, in the United States is around $400,000. If you pull up a mortgage calculator on the web, really easy to do. They usually assume that you're putting down 20%, and you have to put down the 20% to avoid the PMI, private mortgage insurance. So what I'm going to do is make the house $400,000 with 20% down. That'll put the house at $320,000. I'm going to go 30 years, but I want to know what is the payment for mortgage, principal, and interest at these different rates. I'm going to first go back to our default sort, which is sort A1, oldest to newest. I'm going to widen column C. I'm going to type in payment, and then I'm going to do P and I for principal and interest. And in cell C2, because we're working inside a table, it still says table design at the top. We do the formula once, and it will do a calculated column and fill all the way down. What's going to be tricky about this formula is that interest rate in cell B1 is usually 0.0731, but for me, it is sitting here as 7.31. So equal PMT, that's the payment function, tab. It wants to know the rate. The rate is cell B2. I'm going to divide that by 100 first to get it as a percentage, and then I've got to divide it by 12 because there's 12 months in the year. And we make our mortgage payment monthly. So it's B2 divided by 100 divided by 12, comma. The next argument, argument two, is NPER. That is the number of periods. 30 times 12 is 360, but if you want to type out 30 times 12, you can, or you can just type in 360. Comma, present value, how much do you have to, what is the loan amount right now? $400,000 home with 20% down leaves $320,000 to be financed. I'm going to put that $320,000 in as a negative because it'll make the payment positive. That is just how it works. The payment function has five arguments, but we only need three. F, V, and type are in brackets. They're not required and we don't need them. Watch how cool this is. When I press enter, it'll fill this out all the way. I don't have to auto fit down the screen. I know it messed up my chart. I don't care right now. I can fix that later and filter out or lose that. And I'm going to select this payment and just go with, there you go. Looks a little bit better. So there is your payment at those different interest rates. I'm going to once again sort newest to oldest just to show you this. So it is great that we're sitting around 6.3% today. In August of 2024, we were at 6.5, and then in July at 6.85 of 2024. It's great that the mortgage rates are coming down, but you don't really save that much money in the long run. Let's just go figure this out real quick. I'm going to just equal C3 minus C2. So we saved $41.90 a month when we went from 6.5 to 6.3. The issue is the interest rates continue to go down, demand goes up, and the price of homes go up, and you could actually be, even though you're getting a better mortgage rate, you could actually end up paying more for the home because the price is going up, supply and demand. So just something to think about right now. There you go. I hope you enjoyed this. Feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel. My online training classes are below. I will make another video next week, because I'm going to wait till the Fed meets on the September 17th and 18th to see what happens, comparing the current mortgage rate to when the Fed slashed and what happened to home prices to prove that you could actually be paying more when the rates go down. Thank you so much. Have a great day.